Okay, so first of all, this is your second term as chairman, correct?
Right.
So how long have you been chairman of the board?
I'd have to calculate the years, but I want to say 11. Somewhere there is where my term started.
Why did you want to do this?
I didn't have anything else to do, and it seemed like a good thing to do. Real reason.
Okay. How many cases would you say a year the board looks at?
Probably around 275, close to 300.
Really? So that's almost a case a day.
Well, we get them kind of in bunches, like maybe, well, let me tell you the structure. We
Sure.
have 4 pounds.
Okay.
The program is divided into 4 pounds. And each week, a pound is looking at either a case or a couple of cases each week. So when you calculate that, it comes out to about 250, somewhere thereabouts.
Okay, and how big is a panel?
Approximately 21, 22, somewhere like that.
Okay, and all of them look at it together?
No, 1 pound looks at one or two cases of their own.
Okay.
The next week, it's panel A, B, C, D. The next week, panel B gets the cases. The next week, panel C, and so forth. Then if there's a sustained sight on that particular case, then all the panel chairs plus myself, along with 6 members from HPD, will look at that case and make a decision as to whether or not it should have discipline.
Okay, say that again. So is it sustained or?
If that case is sustained, then that case, all the panel chairs, along with some members from HPD, will look at that case again and make a determination what discipline should be recommended to the chief.
To the chief. Okay. So, but who? But it's but that comes after HPD decides if it's sustained or not.
Right.
Does the board decide if something should be
No,
sustained?
no, no.
So what does the board do when it gets a case?
If they look at a case and think it should be sustained, then we can recommend to the chief, this ought to be a sustained case.
Okay, and then if it is sustained, then you recommend discipline, correct?
Right.
Okay. All right. Now.
Then for the 4 pound chairs, plus myself, and along with the group from HPD, we'll look at that case again and decide on the punishment.
Okay, after it's sustained.
Right.
Okay, I understand. Okay. And so when a case comes into the panel, how does that work? Do they just all kind of separately, or do they talk about it, or how does that work?
Yeah, you mean the panel?
Yes.
The case sometimes is that thick, with all kind of information in it. Everything that you can think of pertaining to that person. His past record, his disciplinary record, his evaluations that he's gotten from his division. It's full of stuff that you got to look at and make a determination based on that.
Okay. Does everybody, but I mean, you said each panel is broken up into how many people, 20, 21?
No,
What?
each panel is broken up into five, say.
Okay. Because there's how many board members? 20, how many?
It's roughly 21, yeah.
Yeah, that's right, 21. Okay, and so each, and you're broken into four panels.
Right.
ABCD. Okay. And each panel has its own chair?
Right.
And then you're chairman of the board?
Right.
Okay,
right.
So, okay. So
I break the tie.
You break the tie? Okay. And do you, so there is a vote then?
Yes.
Okay. So let's just kind of give me a quick run through. Say you're on panel A, you get two cases. What's the process from there?
If that case has a sustained sight, then it goes back to IED and then back to legal, and then it'll come back to another panel called ADC. That's the Administrative Discipline Committee. They in turn will now affix the discipline
Right, right,
if
right,
it
right, right.
deems it.
But do you get a case before after you get a case? It sounds like you get a case before there's been a determination whether it should be sustained. Is that correct? Or because you say you can recommend.
Yeah. When we get it, it's just a case put together. And usually there's a recommendation from the division.
Already.
Already.
Okay. So the case has already been put together by HPD.
Right.
Along with typically a recommendation.
Right.
You either agree or disagree with the
Right.
recommendation?
Right.
Okay. Okay, and then after that, there's a vote.
Right.
Okay, and so do you break the tie for each panel?
When I say break the tie, usually I don't have to break
right,
the tie.
Right, because it's easy. Oh, I got you. Okay.
Yeah, usually I don't have to.
Okay.
Only there are times when they can't reach a decision based on some information they they either can't find or don't know. So I'll have to help them research that information. And usually we have to go to internal affairs.
Yeah.
Either that information is in a general order or circular or something. But usually you have to find it.
Okay. Okay. A question just flew out of my head. I apologize for that. Oh, do you get body cam video too?
As a matter of fact, we've got a body cam audit. There's a body worn cam with every case.
Okay.
So if you get a case, there'll be a body worn cam with it.
Okay.
And so you sit down and look at it. Sometimes it takes 35, 40 minutes. Sometimes not very long.
Okay.
And especially if there's something you're looking for specifically.
Okay. But you do get it with each case that you, okay.
As a matter of fact, we do a body worn cam audit. The IPOB, and I say IPOB is Independent Police
right.
Oversight Board. We refer to it as IPOB.
Right.
IPOB, they will do an audit where they give us randomly some body worn cam.
Uh-huh.
We have to sit down and go through them and look for violations, not necessarily violations, but anything that may be contrary to their rules or regulations.
Understood, okay. And how often do you do that?
I think twice a year.
Twice a year?
Mm-hmm.
About how many body cams do they give you?
40.
40. Each time? So 80?
Each time.
80, so about 80?
Right.
And you just watch all 40 of them in each thing and see?
Right.
All panel do that or just one panel?
Well, I have just an audit panel.
Oh, you have just a panel that is just
I pick somebody from, well, I don't pick somebody. I let the person who's going to chair that committee. He will pick four people, one from each, try to get one from each panel.
I understand. Okay, and they form your audit committee.
Right.
Okay. Now, when you get a case or you get this, do you all meet together or do you do it remotely?
Well.
I know it's different now because of COVID,
right.
But typically.
But there's a general order that was put out.
Yeah.
You cannot decide on a case on the phone.
Okay.
You have to meet in person.
Okay.
Now, you can... When a panel gets a case, you can go read your case whenever you want to, 24/7, because we have access to the building. So we can go in and read the case, but you cannot make a decision until you're all sitting in the room together.
Okay, where do you go to view these cases?
HPD, 1200 Travis.
Okay, so you go there.
Uh-huh.
Are you allowed to take anything with you?
No.
So everything is given to you by HPD at headquarters and you have to leave it there?
Right.
Are you allowed to make copies?
No.
Are you allowed to take notes?
Yeah, you can take notes.
Okay, so you can take notes, but you can't make copies of anything or take anything out of the building.
Yeah, but you can understand that, can't you?
Confidentiality.
Right.
Okay.
Because if I bring some stuff home, I tell my neighbor, hey, you know this guy? Oh, let me tell you what he did.
Fair enough, I understand that. What floor is that on, just out of curiosity?
Our place is on 20.
Yours is on the 20th.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And you can go there pretty much, I guess, anytime you want.
Anytime you want to.
Okay. And so that's, it's delivered up there, you look at it up there.
Right.
Are there deadlines for making decisions?
Yes.
What?
When you get a case, you have 14 days.
Uh-huh.
And I think you realize the 14 days involves the collective bargaining agreement. For instance, if a case came on me,
yeah.
From the day they notify me, they have 180 days to make a decision.
Mm-hmm.
You familiar with that?
Yes, sir.
And within that 180 days, everybody in that chain gets that case.
So within that 180 days, everybody has to have it.
Right.
Okay. And are you the last link in that?
I'm the last link until it goes to ADC.
It's a disciplinary.
Then when it leaves ADC, I believe it goes back to legal, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay, and then of course there's the decision after it comes
right.
Back.
And we made the decision that we gave to the chief.
Right. Now do you give your decision directly to the chief or to the ADC?
We make a decision in the room. Then the assistant chief takes note of what everybody agreed on. Then somebody from legal, I'm not sure who does that, they take it to the chief. He makes a decision from that.
Okay. So what assistant chief is in there?
Jones? He's
okay.
The chair.
Okay, he's the chair.
Right.
Of ADC or?
He's chair of ADC.
That's right. Okay. I just want to make sure. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So he basically, you verbally tell him your decision.
Right.
Okay. And he takes notes on that. And then that goes to legal. Somebody from legal then forwards it to the chief.
I, I want to say legal. It may be IAD, but I think it's legal.
Okay.
I'm not that sure on.
But so you're not sure what happens once you give your recommendation.
Right.
Do you have any documents that you fill out for your recommendation? I mean, is there any files for your recommendation?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
There's a form.
There is a form.
That it shows how everybody voted. And that form, for instance, if that case is arbitrated, I understand that form goes to the arbitration.
Right, because it's a legal document.
Right.
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 Okay. So it gives how everybody voted and what their recommendation
was? I've been told that sometimes the arbitrator will ask, how did those civilians vote on this? That kind of stuff.
I understand. Okay. Hey, so do you fill out the form or who fills out the form?
There's a guy. I call him the scribe. He does all that.
Okay. Does he work? Is he with IPOB or is he with
HPD? He's with HPD.
And he's the one who fills out the form.
Right.
Do you sign it? Do you have to sign it or anything?
Yeah, you initial it.
You initial
right.
Next to it? Okay.
Next to your name.
Okay. All right. Okay, that's fine. So, everything going on in the world right now,
mm-hmm.
You've heard there's a lot of calls for more, even Dr. James Douglas, you know, more transparency. People would like to know more about what you do,
mm-hmm.
How you are a check and balance against the system. How do you explain that? When you're not allowed to tell people what you do with these cases.
I probably would say maybe you want to become a part of it. You can do that. It's easy enough to do. And I couldn't assure anybody that, hey, this is a real check and balance. I couldn't do that. I can't. I can tell you that I believe that, but I couldn't convince you if you don't believe it.
Okay. What about the criticism that it's just a rubber stamp?
If I remember correctly, they criticized Jesus Christ. So, criticism is something you expect.
Do you feel that you serve a vital function?
Very much so.
In the police department?
Yes, sir.
How do you believe? Why do you believe that?
Because of the changes we sometimes make changes. For instance, we'll go to the chief and make recommendations on things we think should be changed. So.
Like what?
I don't want to give away any trade secrets, but there have been several things recently that one of the pound chairs recommended that they change. And
you're not even allowed to say what changes are made?
Well, one of the changes would be that maybe we should read some of the documents. I'm going to give you one.
Okay.
One of the changes is some of the documents, before it's released to anybody, we ought to read it to have an idea of what's in that document.
Like what document you're talking about?
Say a shooting case. That kind of stuff.
But there's a lot of documents, and I'm not trying to be obtuse. I'm just trying to understand.
I understand.
What documents do you want to be able to read before it's released?
Say a body-worn camera.
Uh-huh.
Maybe get a chance to view that.
Okay. So are there cases you said have gotten released before IPOBs looked at them?
No, there have been cases. For instance, you've heard them talking about why don't they release this case?
Right.
The case hasn't been finalized yet, but it may help if we got a chance to look at it prior to.
Prior to it being finalized?
Prior to it being finalized.
But technically, I thought you did, don't you? Or
on some, but not the ones that you know it's going to be controversial. No.
Okay.
You don't look at that until it comes with the file.
Okay, so you want to look at cases before the file is put together by IAD.
Right.
Is that
right.
Correct?
Yes.
So in other words, you want more independence.
Well, I mean, if that's what it says, I guess you can say that.
Well, okay. One of the criticisms, too, and I know you've heard this, is the word independent.
Mm-hmm.
Is that you're not really independent because everything's given to you by HPD.
Right.
That you don't have the authority to go on your own and ferret out information.
Well, for me to do that, I'd have to be an investigator. Say there was a homicide across the street. For me to do a lot of the things that people want you to do, I'd have to go investigate that case. And we're not investigators. I'm not trained to investigate. I couldn't investigate a case.
Do you feel you need subpoena powers?
That's a term that I'm kind of going to stay away from because
okay.
there's too much being said about it. So I'd rather stay away from that term.
Okay. Okay, okay, fair enough. Let me ask it this way then.
Okay.
Do you feel that you get all the information you need to make a full and fair assessment of each case?
That question is asked all the time, and I say, I don't recall anything I asked for that somebody said, well, you can't look at that. So the answer to your question is, I think I do.
Okay, you think you do. Okay. Uh-huh. But the one recommendation about seeing something, so have they changed that? Did they make that change yet? Or is it being considered?
It's being considered, and that's why I didn't want to say very much about it. Because,
okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
No, I get it. But one thing, you would like to see information prior to IAD putting the whole file together.
Right.
Because by the time you get it, it's usually a decision, somebody somewhere in the department has made a decision, or at least a recommendation, rather.
Right. Say. Yeah. Okay. There you go. Recommendation.
So you'd like to be, I guess, you'd be like to move up in the chain?
Kind of ahead of the game, yeah.
So you'd like to be a little more ahead of the game?
Right.
Okay,
right.
Fair enough. Okay, fair enough about this. Now, what about, as far as the public transparency, the people who's like, well, just like, we want to see, how many cases have you done this year? Some kind of metric as to what exactly you've done. And I'm not knocking you, because I know it's a lot of cases.
Right.
But the public's complaint is, we really don't know what you do.
You don't. And I go, say, to a few civic clubs and explain to people. And people are surprised that even what we do, no matter what the amount, they're surprised at that. Some people don't have any idea. So I don't know how to, it's kind of out of my area as to how to get everybody involved to know what's going on. I'm not sure if I could do that.
Okay. Would you be in favor of at least some level of public disclosure? And with that said, I get. I mean, you can't just start releasing things willy-nilly because people are found in it. I mean, I get that. But some more public disclosure as to what you do. Like, I mean, you yourself said some people are surprised that you're there.
Yeah. I don't know how you get to everybody, because some people are only interested when something comes up. So I could go someplace every night and talk about what we do. That'd be that group that would say, you never came here, or whatever. So I don't know how you reach all those people.
Okay. I know that you can make recommendations to the chief. Do you have any idea how many times you've disagreed with the chief? Or a chief has disagreed, let me ask you this way. Do you know how many times the chief has disagreed with an IPOB recommendation?
I maintain a book. Well, I don't maintain a book, but there's a book that shows what we recommended and what he did. Mm-hmm. And I would say probably no more than 10%. So probably 90% of our recommendation. And the next question you probably would ask, why would he disagree? And I'll use an analogy. If we recommend that a guy be fired because he ran into that tree, then on the day of reckoning, the guy comes in where a mechanic has proven that car, the brakes fail, then he won't fire him, because it's not his fault. But that was our recommendation.
Right, that's exculpatory evidence came to light. Well, that's not necessarily a disagreement, just new evidence came to light.
Well,
yeah.
Call it what you will, but that happens a lot.
Okay, so you're saying, but about 90% of the time, the board and whoever was the chief, because I know it goes beyond Acevedo, are in agreement with the recommendations.
Right.
Okay. You have the authority to go to the OIG if you don't feel HPD has done a thorough enough visit.
Right.
How many times over the years has the board done that?
Not many. I met with her last week, but only to let some of the people know that we had that avenue. She came to meet with us and explained. She even gave us some booklet. Here's what you do if you disagree with whatever. Here's my number. She gave our card. So.
Who is this?
The OIG.
She came to you guys?
Yeah.
Shouldn't that have, I mean, my understanding, when this was set up under Mayor Parker, you've always had that. Why is the OIG just now coming to the board?
No.
Hey, this is what we can do.
I didn't mean to imply that was the first time.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. She's been there before, but she's just reminding us that she's there.
Okay.
Which I thought was a good thing.
Okay. So just reminding you again.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you don't know offhand how many times the board's gone to the OIG?
No, I don't have a number.
Okay, okay. Do you think it's ever happened?
Well, I don't recall it happening, because I haven't had a reason to go to. I'm telling you, if you go to one of the chiefs and you have to get to the big chief, chances are whatever you're asking for, you're going to get. That's what I found.
Okay. So you don't think there's ever been a need to go to the LA?
I don't.
Okay. And then the book that's maintained with the recommendations and all that, is that also confidential?
Yeah.
Okay. You can't even release statistics?
Well, yeah, I could release the statistics, but I haven't compiled it.
Okay.
So I don't notice it. I don't.
Okay.
And I gave you a rough guess.
Understood.
Okay. Yeah.
And who maintains that book?
It's locked in a file in our room on a lock and key with all the other files.
Okay, at HPD. Okay.
Yeah. Any member can look at it if they need to.
Sure.
Why would anybody else need to look at it? I mean, that.
You know, the word of the day is transparency.
I understand.
And so people are calling for more transparency. Would you be in agreement? Would do you feel the board needs more authority to do its job, to do its work? More independence?
Based on what the executive order says, no. Based on what the executive order says. Now, if you ask me to do something different, I'd say, well, we need more authority to do that. But
like
based
what?
On how, I can't think of anything off the top, but I'm saying, your question is, do we need more authority? But to do what we do with the executive order, no.
Okay. Do you feel it's truly independent?
I do. Well, maybe not 100%, 95%, maybe. That's close. So I'd say yes.
Okay. Because there's been some talk about possibly moving you out, just like physically moving the offices out, you know, so it could be independent.
Well, there's also talk of us investigating cases. But like I said, there's talk about a lot of things, so I'm not sure what's going to happen. And I'm sure something's going to happen. I just don't know what it is.
And forgive me, what was your background before taking on this volunteer? I want to go back to one thing. One person did say that one thing that could help you is if you had a paid staff, and you don't, because it's all volunteer, isn't it?
Right, yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's all paid. My background. I knew, for some reason, I knew you were going to ask me that.
Sure.
You're talking about my work or my education?
Which one? Work, just what you did before you took on this.
I was a postal clerk when I started, and when I left, I was director of mail processing in Northern Virginia.
Oh, well, how did you make your way down to Houston?
I'm from here.
Oh, you're from here originally?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you get transferred for the postal?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
That's great. How long were you with the Postal Service?
32 years.
That's quite an impressive. It's an impressive run. Wow.
Yeah.
All right. And then, so how do you choose board members? What's the process? How does that work?
They go to boards and commission, mm-hmm. and apply. Mm-hmm. And we kind of do a mock interview, and let me tell you why. Mm-hmm. There are some people I found that want to do things for different reasons. Mm-hmm. And if you talk to somebody, you'll say, well, why do you want to be on this? And you talk to him a few minutes, you'll discover he's had a bad experience, and he feels, hey, this is my chance to get even, this is my chance to do something else. And so, but basically, just about everybody who applies, now you can't have a felony, you can't have a high-level misdemeanor, your background got to be pretty clean. Can't have a relative.
Oh, that's on the force?
Right.
Okay. Yeah, because that would be a conflict.
Right.
Okay.